Meanwhile, the U.S. Senate rejects a resolution to force a human rights report on Israel's offensive in Gaza. 72 senators voted to kill the resolution in the 100-member chamber. The measure would have frozen security aid to Israel unless the U.S. State Department produces a report within 30 days examining whether Israel committed human rights violations in Gaza. Washington gives Israel $3.8 billion in military assistance each year. Biden has asked Congress to approve an additional $14 billion. Google confirms that it is eliminating, quote, a few hundred positions from its global ad team. This amid a push to use AI for efficiency and creativity. The internet giant says the job cuts in its so-called large customer sales team are intended to result in better support for small and medium-sized businesses advertising on Google's platform. Google laid off around 12,000 people this time last year, or about 6% of its workforce, in the face of high inflation and rising interest rates. A bill to avert a partial U.S. government shutdown this weekend clears the first hurdle in the Senate. The legislation is intended to give the U.S. Congress more time to pass a $1.59 trillion spending measure before funding for dozens of government agencies expires on Friday. The Senate voted 68-13 to begin debates on the temporary funding bill, moving it closer to passage. Once passed, the House is expected to promptly act on it. The program, an overnight decline on Wall Street, weighing down on market sentiment here in Asia. U.S. stocks ended lower on Tuesday after mixed earnings report from major banks pressured lenders. Morgan Stanley opens new tab, tumbled 4.2% to a more than one-month low after it posted a lower quarterly profit. While Goldman Sachs opens new tab stock ended 0.7% higher after it reported a 51% rise in profit. Federal Reserve Governor Christopher Waller also dampened sentiment by saying there should be no rush to cut interest rates. This even after he noted that the U.S. is, quote, within striking distance of the Fed's 2% inflation goal. Take a look now at major stock indices in Asia. We're seeing a sea of red across the board. Chinese markets seeing deep cuts, with Hong Kong's Hang Seng decreasing by over 3% following the release of Beijing's GDP data. China's economy saw a 5.2% year-on-year growth in the fourth quarter, which is a touch lower than analysts' expectations of 5.3%. The world's second-largest economy has been struggling to mount a strong post-COVID bounce, burdened by a protracted property crisis, weak consumer and business confidence, mounting local government debts, and weak global growth. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. The gloom in Asia is expected to continue in Europe, with investors also seen to stay cautious ahead of inflation numbers out of the Eurozone. Contracts tied to the German DAX are down more than 0.7%. Stateside now, futures on Wall Street are also pointing to a lower open. The earnings season set to gain steam this week. Qatar and France broker a new deal to allow more aid into Gaza. The new agreement will allow urgent medication to be delivered to dozens of Israeli hostages in the enclave. In return, civilians in Gaza will receive more humanitarian and medical supplies. The deliveries will leave Qatar for Egypt Wednesday night. Over 100 of the 240 people whom Hamas militants abducted on October 7 remain in captivity. President Marcos Sarin, the Health Secretary's recommendation to suspend the premium rate hike of state insurer PhilHealth once again. Secretary Ted Herbosa told the president he's not in favor of increasing the PhilHealth premium from 4% to 5% because it will be an added burden to Filipinos. Herbosa will also raise his position in the PhilHealth board meeting today. The hike is scheduled under the Universal Healthcare Law. PhilHealth is expecting some 17 billion pesos in additional funds because of the premium increase. The Philippine Transportation Department opened to talks with transport groups over the PUV modernization program beyond the January 31 deadline. In a press briefing, DOTR Secretary Jaime Bautista admitted various challenges remain in its push to modernize jeepneys. By the end of the month, the extension given to unconsolidated jeepneys will lapse and they will no longer be allowed to ply their routes. Transport groups which oppose the modernization program are planning to mount another protest caravan this month.
Yung protesta ay karapatan no ng bawat mamamayan no na kailangang ipahiwatig nila yung kanilang damdamin, ang kanilang nasa sa loob no. Pero po kami dito sa DOTR no, sa LTFRB and yung mga attached agencies namin na ay sinasabi pa rin namin na bukas yung aming opisina na makipag-usap sa kanila. Inuulit namin na although na nagkaroon na tayo ng tinatawag na deadline no, mayroon pa rin mga deadline sa consolidation, may mga issues pa rin no, na kami naman dito sa office ay handang makipag-usap.
Meanwhile, the Land Transportation Office revealed in that press briefing nearly half of jeepneys that held franchises last year were not registered.
Pag sila ipapasada na hindi naman sila nakirehistro, ayon sa batas, hindi pwede gawin yan. So, mapipilitan po namin i-impound yan. It's an impoundable offense, no? Sana wag na po nila gawin yan kasi although pinaghahandaan na rin po namin yan.